brothers and sisters, thank you for turning out. I know that we jam-packed the Sheraton. A lot of folks couldn't get in. But we had the room looking real good. Blue shirts all over the place. Management got the message loud and clear. And the message is that transit workers are in this fight to the end. And we're going to defend our livelihoods. And we're not going to let this company come in and gut our contract. We're going to fight them tooth and nail. We're going to fight them to the end to win a contract. TWU is going to fight its own contract and fight for a wage increase. And we don't really care what the other union's done in New York State, because we're the TWU and they're not. We deserve a fair and reasonable wage increase. We didn't cause this economic crisis, and this economic crisis is not going to be solved off the backs of Local 100 members. Solve it with the banks if you want. Solve it with the wealthiest New Yorkers if you want, but you're not solving it off the backs of us. We're averaging right now 3 or 4 assaults on bus operators every single week. 3 or 4 assaults on bus operators. If 3 or 4 MTA bosses were getting assaulted every week, the problem would have been fixed 10 years ago. But because it isn't bosses getting beat up on our buses, they took their time and they dragged their feet. We need a no layoff clause. Central contract demand. A no layoff clause. An ironclad no layoff clause. We're gonna fight for it. And with your involvement, and with Local 100 members fighting it out on the tracks, fighting it out in the bonds and in the depots, and the station platforms, we can win this fight. The MTA has a problem with women on this job. A central aspect of this contract fight is to win a fair, reasonable, safe, and respectful workplace for our Local 100 ladies. We're gonna make a wage demand for paid maternity leave. Paid maternity leave. Go to Europe. Paid maternity leave and paternity leave and paternity leave are commonplace. Come to New York City Transit, a woman gets pregnant, they want to kick her to the side as if she's some sort of commodity. A pregnant transit worker is a hassle to this company. There's absolutely no respect for our ladies or for our families. We need to fight tooth and nail to make that end. At the age of getting to the end of your route, and looking for a Burger King that might or might not have a working bathroom, those days have to end. The company's responsible to provide safe and clean and sanitary facilities for us, particularly our women, and it's gonna be a central demand in this contract fight. We need overhaul. A complete overhaul of the disciplinary system. It's designed to hurt workers and hinder workers, whether they're being disciplined or whether they're injured on the job and trying to get fair compensation for an injury that occurred at work. We need to change it. The only way we're going to make these changes and the others that I mentioned is to dig our boots in and fight this company. The beginning of this is the turnout tonight. The turnout tonight was absolutely tremendous. The room upstairs was absolutely packed out with placards, with blue shirts. Management got the message. In fact, I think they were a little concerned about actually trying to exit out of the room in a safe manner. But let them get a taste of what we go through every day on our buses and our station platforms about whether or not we're going to get safe passage back and forth from point to point.